Hello, this is Eric Bolt from the National Weather Service in Oxnard, California. Here is an update on El Nino and the latest predictions for the upcoming winter season across Southwest California. We have been in El Nino since last March, and it continues to strengthen. El Nino has been in a strong category since October 1st, and this could rank among the top three strongest events since 1950. Early November sea surface temperature anomaly continues to reflect classic El Nino conditions across the tropical, central, and eastern Pacific Ocean. The latest ENSO 3.4 region average temperature shown in the black box is 3.1 degrees Celsius. This is the strongest temperature anomaly recorded in this region in 65 years, and much above the 2.4 degrees Celsius recorded in October. The latest El Nino reading is in second place when compared to the two strongest El Ninos since 1950. The black line is where we are currently, just behind the 97-98 strong event shown in blue, and just ahead of the 82-83 event in green. El Ninos typically peak in strength during the winter months and then weaken during the spring and summer. Computer models are mainly predicting that this winter's El Nino will be a strong event. The yellow line is the model average predicted for this winter season, and it peaks between 2 and 2.5 degrees Celsius, well above the 1.5 degree threshold for a strong El Nino event. All past strong El Ninos since measurements began in 1950 have resulted in above normal rainfall for downtown Los Angeles. This chart shows the past six strong events, along with the precipitation amounts during the 4 years prior to the El Nino season. Average rainfall for downtown is a little over 15 inches per year, and during strong El Ninos, rainfall has ranged roughly from 20 to over 30 inches. Looking across the entire state of California during the past six strong El Ninos since 1950 shows that precipitation has historically been above average across southern areas, while northern areas have been mixed. In these two strong events, much of central and northern California have been below average for the year, and this is significant as most of the large reservoirs are in this part of the state. Less precipitation in this region is a concern for drought relief and water supply for much of California.
With El Nino predicted through the upcoming winter season, here is the precipitation outlook for the rainy season months of January through March. There is a greater than 60% chance of being wetter than normal across Southwest California. Normal annual rainfall ranges from about 15 to 25 inches across the area. The temperature outlook for the January through March time frame calls for having slightly warmer than normal temperatures for the three-month period. A higher chance of above normal temperatures are depicted across Northern California. Here are some conclusions about this winter's El Nino. El Nino tilts the odds of above normal rainfall for Southwest California this winter. A strong El Nino, and among the top three strongest, is predicted. One El Nino winter will not end the drought. And prior to the rains, we still have a high potential for large wildfires. More numerous storms are expected this winter compared with other winters, especially January through March. Some of the potential impacts we should prepare for include coastal flooding. This can occur from the combination of surf and high tide episodes inundating low-lying areas and parking lots with water near the beaches. Another potential winter impact is coastal damage. This can occur from large surf events generated by strong Pacific Ocean storms and be more significant when combined with a storm surge and high tide. Damage to vessels, docks, piers, homes, and beach structures will be possible. And another potential impact is floods. Flash flooding can occur during any short-duration heavy rain event. However, widespread flooding is more likely when the region becomes saturated after several storms in a row and little break between systems. Most Southern California flood events are associated with long-duration atmospheric rivers, aka Pineapple Express, that provide a continuous feed of subtropical moisture over the area for several days.
What should you do to prepare for El Nino? Stay aware of weather predictions this winter. You can do that by following the National Weather Service on social media and the web.
or listen to local media on TV, radio, or the internet. Prepare and take action now by improving your drainage or water issues you have around your property. Check your emergency kits. Think about flood insurance if that's been a problem in the past for water issues around your property. And also make sure you know how to be notified during these storm events. Thank you for listening to this presentation. Here is my contact information along with our website and social media channels.